It's time to talk about Power Automate and Excel. Power Automate is a tool you already have access to if you have Office 365. Now, it's even available in the free version of Office, but it's limited to what it can do. Now, if you have no idea what Power Automate is, I got you covered. I have a step-by-step video that shows you how easy it is to use it and how much time you can save with it. Link is in the description. Right now, we're going to combine this power with Excel. I'm going to show you two examples of useful automations that you can create with Excel. Number one is to record your working hours by clicking a button on your phone. So whenever you start to work, you click a button and it's going to record the time and date to an Excel table. When you stop working, just click that again to record the end of your work time. The second automation that I'm going to show you will be triggered from Excel. This automation will create a LinkedIn post directly from your Excel file. So you select the row and you run the flow, and your row will be turned into a post which will be live on LinkedIn. We're going to set this up together. It's really exciting stuff. So let's start with recording our working hours. Before I create my automation, my first step is to create a workbook where I'm going to be collecting the working hours. So let's start off with a blank workbook. Now I need to have a table in there with the fields I want to document. One is going to be date, another one is going to be time, and I also want to know if I've started the task or if I'm ending the task. So I'm going to put type here. Now the second step is to turn this into an Excel table. Let's just highlight this, go to Insert and select Table. You can also use the shortcut key Control T. My table has headers and go with OK. Just to give this table a better name, I'm going to go to Table Design and update the name to Table Time. Now because I'm creating a cloud flow, I'm going to save this either on my OneDrive or on SharePoint. In this case, I'm going to save it on OneDrive. Let's use Control S and save it under the folder called Z Automate. Now I'll give this a better name and click on Save. Next step is to log into office.com, go to Apps and select Power Automate. The flow that we're going to create is going to be triggered by us. We can create it from scratch by going to Create. The instant cloud flow allows you to trigger this manually as you need. So we're going to go with that. Give this flow a name. I'll call it record working hours. And we want to manually trigger this from our mobile. So select this and click on create. First step was added. We have the ability to add additional inputs. So when we click on the plus here, you can add text input, yes, no, file, email, number, and date. I want to go with yes, no, because I want to track whether I'm starting or ending my working hours. So I'm going to update this to start and add a question mark. And instead of please select yes or no, let's update this to yes for start and no for end. This way we know whether we're starting to work or we're ending our work. Next, let's add a new step. This time I want to add a new row to my Excel file. So I need Excel Online for Business. My action is to add a row into a table, which I can see right here. So let's select that. Next step is to define the location of my file. So just click on the dropdown and select where it is. In this case, mine is OneDrive for Business. The document library is OneDrive, and the file itself can be selected by clicking on the show picker icon, selecting your folder, so mine is in Z Automate, and the file is right here. Next, I can select the table that's in that file. So Power Automate automatically scans for tables, and it's noticed that there is a table called Table Time. That's the one I need. And immediately I get new fields. These are my column headers in Table Time. I added a date column, a time column, and a type column. So for date, what do we want to be in there? I want it to be dynamic content, and I want to record the date. So the moment I click that button on my mobile, the date should be recorded. Next, for time, I would like to have the timestamp, which is another thing I can see under dynamic content. So let's go with that. type is what I added myself because I want to know whether I'm starting or ending my working day. So I want to have this variable in here. Now, I should see it under dynamic content already. And if you happen not to see it, you can just type it in here and then select it. I'm going to go with start. And that's it. Let's save this flow and test it out. So you can test this out directly from here as well, but it's more fun to test it directly from mobile. So let's switch to my mobile app and let's run this flow. To trigger the flow, you need to go to the Power Automate app on your device. Now, this is a free app and you can easily download it from the App Store. Just go into it, go to the button side, and you should see your flow listed here. Select it. It's asking us, is it yes for start, no for end? Yes, I'm starting to record my hours. So I'm going to go with that, click on OK, and done. And now the flow started and my timestamp should be in my Excel file. So let's switch back to Excel and see if it's there. My file is right here. Let's see if we have everything recorded. That's date, that's time, and the type. So the type shows true if we're starting our working hours, and it's going to be false if we go with no, which means the data type for this is Boolean. Now, there are two things I would like to update here. One is for the timestamp. I just want to have the time and I want to have it in a readable format. And for type, I want to change the true and false to be start or end. This is where you can use functions in Power Automate. So let's go back to our flow and update this accordingly. Let's start with updating the type. So here, instead of true or false, I want to see start or end. This is where I can use a function or an expression. And guess what? Power Automate has the if function. And this works very similar to Excel. We get to test for a condition, what we want if it's true, and what we want if it's false. Now, I want this condition to be based on my dynamic content. So let's just switch my view to dynamic content and select start. Next, what do we want if it's true? Well, I want to see start, and if it's false, I want to see end. Now here we have to currently use single quotes for that. So put start in single quotes, otherwise end in single quotes, and make sure the bracket is closed and okay. We put our dynamic content inside the if function. Next, for the timestamp. Here I want to format this to just hour and minute. I can use an expression, and if we just search for expressions that include the word format, we can see format date time. Now here, when we open the bracket, we see that we need a string that contains the time and then the type of format that we want. Now, sometimes when you switch to dynamic content, you can't see your variables here, and it might not be obvious how to refer to them. What you can do is just to hover over them. So notice when I hover over timestamp, I get this long code. That's actually what I want. When I hover over date, that's what I get. To be able to easily copy this name or this code, I can switch to code view. So click on the more options here and go to peak code. The label I saw there was this one. So I'm just going to copy it, click on done, and go back to writing my expression. My expression was to format date time. Let's open bracket and paste in the code that I copied. Next is the format I want. I'm going to put the format in single quotes. I want HH colon MM for hours and minutes. Make sure we have the bracket closed there and click on OK. Now I'm going to get rid of the timestamp. Okay, so let's save this. And let's test this one directly in here. So go to test. I'm going to run it manually, save and test. Here I can choose start or start is off, which means it's end. So I'm going to leave it like this and run the flow. Click on done. Now I should see this update here and be able to see the time it took for this to run. Now when I switch to my Excel, I already see it here. I have my timestamp properly and I get end instead of false. Now you can easily run this from your mobile anytime you start your work. Just go to the app, select the button, and you'll have a date, you'll have a time, and you'll have the type. You can then later create reports to analyze your working hours. Now let's quickly take a look at our second flow. we're going to set this up the other way around. So we are going to create a LinkedIn post directly from a row in an Excel table. I'm back in the Power Automate app. I'm in Create, and I'm going to create an instant Cloudflow. Let's call this LinkedIn posts. And this time, my trigger isn't a button on the mobile app. Instead, it's for a selected row in Excel. So I'm going to go with this and create the flow. So first of all, we need to define the file and the table that we're using to create our LinkedIn posts. Well, this time I've already set it up. So I've created an Excel table that has two columns, URL and text. So I want my LinkedIn post to include a link to this article on my site, and I want it to have this text. Now, this is formatted as a table, and the table is called Table Posts. The file is called LinkedIn Posts and is saved on my OneDrive for Business. So now let's go ahead and define the location. It's OneDrive for Business. The document library is OneDrive. My file, well, let's go and find it. It's in folder Z Automate, and it's called LinkedIn Posts. Now, when I click on the dropdown, I'm going to see the tables in that file. That's my table. Now, I can also add any additional inputs that I want, but in this case, I don't need them. I'm going to go ahead and add a new step. Let's search for LinkedIn. We're going to go with the most recent version. Under Actions, I want to share a company update. So let's go with that. Now, at this point, if you haven't authenticated yourself, you will need to log in to LinkedIn with your email and password. I've already done that, so I can go ahead and select my company. Now, these are automatically filled once you log in to LinkedIn. For the content URL, well, for this, I'm going to use dynamic content because remember, my table has two columns, URL and text. That's the one I want. So for content URL, we're going to go with dynamic content, and I see right here, URL formatted. Next, is this visible to guests? Well, let's go with yes. Now, I also want to add some text to this, so I'm going to go with advanced options, and for text, let's go with dynamic content again and select our second column, which was text. Okay, so all of this looks good. Click on save. Okay, so now we're ready to go. Let's go ahead and run this flow. So I've opened this file on Excel Online, and if it's the first time you're working with flows in Excel Online, you have to add it to your tab. You can do that by going to Insert, Office Add-ins, go to Store, and search for the add-in flow. You can also type in Power Automate. This should come up here. It's Microsoft Flow for Excel. Click on Add. Now I'm going to continue. And once it's installed, you're going to see the flow option in the data tab. Now I'm going to select this one to post. So just click somewhere that's on the same row. You don't have to necessarily select the entire row, and then click on flow. Now at this point, you should see the flow that you just created, and that's connected to this file here. And that's the LinkedIn post. So I'm going to run the flow. First time you run this, you have to authenticate yourself, and it's already done here. So click on continue and run the flow. So now we should see this post on LinkedIn. Okay, so this is about dashboard tips. Let me bring up my other browser here. I'm already logged into LinkedIn. I'm on the Excel Plus page. So let's refresh this to see if we get to see our post here. And it's right here. I hope this video gave you some ideas on how you can use Power Automate and combine it with Excel. Comment below and let me know what you think. And also, if you're currently using Power Automate, let us know how you're using it. If you like this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you aren't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing so that we can get to see each other more often. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.